Hello all, my name is Krishnak and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are basically going to discuss about Gaussian or normal distribution. Now in my previous video, I have already explained to you about population, sample, population mean, sample mean, and we have also understood about random variable and its various types. So let us take an example to understand this particular distribution, what this distribution basically says. So let us consider X as some random variable, okay? And this basically belongs to a Gaussian distribution or a normal distribution with some mean and sigma value, mean and standard deviation, okay? And I can also write it as variance square. So sorry, variance. Variance is given by sigma square, but right now we are just going to consider sigma, okay? Now, if we know that this X variable follows a Gaussian distribution, if we take this random variable X, and if we try to plot with the help of histogram and something called as probability density function, then we will be seeing that we will be getting this kind of curve. And this curve is nothing but it is basically called as a bell curve. Now inside this curve, the central point is my median. If I go one position to the right, this is my mu plus sigma. If I go one position to the left, this is my mu minus sigma. Similarly, one more position, if I go to the right, it is mu plus 2 sigma. This is mu plus 3 sigma. If I go to the left, mu minus 2 sigma and mu minus 3 sigma. Okay, now this region specifies the range of first standard deviation. So this region specifies the first range of first standard deviation. This region is my second range of standard deviation. I mean range of second standard deviation, and similarly for the range of third standard deviation. Now this bell curve is very, very important thing. And if this random variable follows a Gaussian distribution, it also has three properties. Now that properties are basically called as empirical formula. Empirical formula. Now what does this empirical formula specify? The first formula basically says that the probability of a variable, right, that falls within the range of mu minus sigma and mu plus sigma, which is basically my range of first standard deviation, will approximately be equal to 68%. Okay, again, I'm right saying that. What does this mean? 68% of the data points belonging to the random variable X fall within the range of first standard deviation. Very much simple. And why we are saying that? Because this random variable belongs to a Gaussian distribution. Now, similarly, the second point says that the probability of a variable that falls between mu minus 2 sigma and mu plus 2 sigma. When I say this variable belongs to this random variable, okay? This is approximately somewhere around 95%. This is somewhere approximately around 95%. Now, what does this specify? This specifies 95% of the data points belonging to this random variable fall within the range of two standard deviation, okay? And the third point says that probability of mu minus 3 sigma less than or equal to X mu plus 3 sigma will be approximately equal to 99.7%. Now this specifies that 99.7% of data points belonging to the random variable X lies within the range of 3 standard deviation. Now this is the most important properties, because guys, whenever we will be considering any data set, okay, and when we are doing exploratory data analysis, if we try to plot some of the features, it will basically be having this kind of curve, first of all. And when it follows this kind of curve, these three properties also get applied to it, because it is a Gaussian distribution. And with the help of these three things, you'll be understanding how we can basically apply all these particular things while doing exploratory data analysis. In the later stages, in my next videos, I'll also be explaining you about something called a standard normal distribution. And there is where you'll be understanding why do we do feature scaling also. Okay. We can also convert this normal distribution to standard normal distribution. And for that, we also again have a different formula. And from there, Z scores gets derived. And this is how we are going to understand all those things. So I hope you like this particular video. Please do subscribe the channel if you have not already subscribed. I will again come up with another interesting video in my next one. Till then, have a great day ahead. Thank you one and all.